మోదకేన అరుణ కుసుమమాల జ్ఞాన లంబోదరం తం మమ హృదయ నివాసం శ్రీ గణేశం నమామి కృష్ణ ప్రదా కృష్ణ పరంత రాత్రౌ చ కృష్ణం పునరుత్థితాయి తే కృష్ణ దేహం ప్రవిశంతి కృష్ణం ఆజ్యం యథా మంత్రోక్తం హుతాశీ రామాయ రామభద్రాయ రామచంద్రాయ వేదతే రఘునాథాయ నాథాయ సీతాయా పతయే నమః బుద్ధిర్బలం యశోధైర్యం నిర్భయత్వమరోగత అజాగ్రం మత్పడుత్వం చ హనుమత్స్మరణాత్ భవేత్ చిత్రైపదైశ్చ గంభీరై వాక్యమానైర ఖండితై గురుభావం వ్యంజయంతి భారతిశ్రీలేతీర్థవాక్ ప్రణమత్కామధేనుం చ భజత్ స్ఫురతరూపమం శ్రీభావబోధకృత్పాద చింతామణిం పాస్మహే పూజ్యాయ రాఘవేంద్రాయ సత్యధర్మరతాయ చ భజతాం కల్పవృక్షాయ నమతాం కామధేనవే అన్నపూర్ణే సదా పూర్ణే శంకర ప్రాణవల్లభే జ్ఞానవైరాగ్య సిద్ధ్యర్థం భిక్ష్యాం దేహీ చ పార్వతీ హయగ్రీవ హయగ్రీవ హయగ్రీవేతి యోవదే తస్య నిస్సరతే వాణీ జన్ను కన్యా ప్రవాహవత్ రాకాచంద్ర సమాన కాంతి వదనా నాకాధిరాజస్తుతా మూకానామపి కుర్వతి సురధునే వాక్వైభవం శ్రీకాంక్షే నగరి విహార రసికా శోకాపహంత్రీ సతాం ఏకా పుణ్య పరంపర పశువతే ఆకారిణే రాజతే సత్యం విధాతుం నిజ ప్రత్యభాషితం వ్యాప్తిం చ భూతేషు అఖిలేషు చాత్మనః అదృశ్యత అత్యద్భుత రూపముద్వహన్ తం భేతమాయాం న మృగం న మానుషం.
I'm one of the dutas of the great Lord who crossed the ocean and came to see you here, Mother. My name is Hanuman. That is how he introduces. She can't believe. And then she says, long before Norman Vincent Peale wrote his book on positive thinking, the Ramayana says,
కళ్యాణీ పతగాతేయం లౌకికి ప్రతిభాతిమే ఏతి జీవంతమానందం నరం వర్ష శతాత్తపి నరం వర్ష శతాత్తపి ఈవెన్ ఇఫ్ యు హావ్ టు లివ్ 100 ఇయర్స్ యు విల్ హావ్ యువర్ రైటియస్ డిజైర్స్ ఫుల్ఫిల్ డోంట్ గివ్ అప్ హోప్ మై డియర్ లిసనర్స్ డోంట్ గివ్ అప్ హోప్
యు హావ్ రెడ్ దట్ ఓల్డ్ నావెల్ కాల్డ్ కౌంట్ ఆఫ్ మోంటే క్రిస్టో హౌ లాంగ్ ఇట్ టేక్స్ ఫర్ ఎ మ్యాన్ టు వెయిట్ 18 ఇయర్స్ ఇన్ ప్రిజన్ You can wait to see your hopes fulfilled. Never give up hope. This is what Mother Sita says. The same line is going to be repeated by Bharata when Hanumanji is going to meet Bharata and tell him the Lord has come to Bharadwaja's ashram. Now she's asking him, what is it that you want to tell me? How much you talk about the Lord? And more you talk about the Lord, I feel attracted towards the speech of yours that describes my master. Tell me, are you an authentic messenger of the Lord? When a good man has to prove himself again and again as good, it's a very embarrassing situation. Finally, he wants to give the proof. He takes the signet ring of Sri Rama, puts it in the center of his hand and says, Ma, I am the authentic messenger of Sri Rama. I have brought a signet ring which is name inscribed on it.
Vanaroham Mahabhage Duto Ramasya Dhimataha Rama Namankitam Chedam Pashyadevi Anguliyakam Pashyadevi Vanaroham Pashyadevi Duto Ramasya Dhimataha.
You want the final proof? Here is Rama's ring, which is name inscribed, the one that he wore in the wedding. Same ring. I'm just an ordinary Vanara mother, but I've been sent by the Lord, authentic messenger of the Lord. Please believe me. Why did he not give it to her? Because if he gives it to her, Lakshmi's hand will be below the hand of Hanuman, and that's why he says, see, you can't give anything to Lakshmi. Pashyadevi anguliyakam pashyadevi, and she takes this. My dear brothers, all of you know men are from Mars and women from Venus. Most of you don't have sentiment at all. I'm talking of brothers. I have every right to shout at them because they even forget the wedding day. And on the wedding day, the poor lady dresses herself beautifully, put flowers in her hair, nice tilakam, lot of bangles, and then she's walking up and down. He's asking her, what's wrong with you? You have forgotten that today is our wedding day. The man forgets because he is from Mars and women are from Venus. The woman has sentiment for every little token that has been given by her husband. That is why Desdemona's handkerchief was so famous, I hope you remember. I'm sure every woman here keeps the first sari that her husband gave. When the daughter-in-law says that sari, she says, no, that was given by your father-in-law. That is for me. First gift, first gift. She can never forget that. And when Mother Sita sees the ring of Rama, Champu Ramayana says, on the day of the wedding, she was very happy. But today, she is 100 times more happy than that day when she got married to Rama. What did you say, my child? What did you say you are? Single person flying across the ocean, coming into the lion's den, coming into the home of the enemy alone? You call yourself a vanara? No, my son. Vikrantastvam samarthastvam pragnyastvam vanarottama. On one side, my Lord Rama described the glory of Hanuman. On the other side, Mother Sita describes the glory of Hanuman. You are a beautiful combination of brawn, brain, bravery and beauty, my son. Nobody is like you. Vikrantastvam, samarthastvam, pragnyastvam, vanarottama. He must be bowing down to her. No, mother, no. Don't praise me so much. Yes, my son, yes. I want to know, does Rama ever think of me? My dear sisters, a couple of friends along with your husband go abroad. The friends come back and your husband has some more office work. So you ask them, how is your brother there? Oh, Amma, he is very happy. Having a gala type. What casinos, what parties, what celebrations. One moment you'll take the phone and bang him. Suppose this man says, oh, you don't know, Amma. How much he misses you. Everywhere he remembers you. Every beautiful sight, every beautiful home. Hill and dale and mountain, everywhere he thinks of you, good food he thinks of you, good clothes he thinks of you, you'll be very happy. Every wife wants to listen to the report that her husband is missing her. Ramayana says, the confirmed bachelor called Hanuman is telling the mother, you don't know, the whole world is concentrating on Rama and Rama is concentrating on you. That is what is happening right now.
Naiva dhanushan na mashakan na kitan na saritripan raghavo apanayet gatra tvadgatena antaratmana. Even if serpents are crawling on him, he doesn't brush them.
Sita, 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 Sita. All the time it is Sita.
And he doesn't sleep at all. Suppose he falls asleep because he is tired.
You can imagine thousands of vanaras watching Rama sleeping. Sugriva says, shh, Rama is sleeping. They're all watching him sleeping. How happy they must be to watch him sleep. But you come in his dream and he gets up and says, Sita, 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 Sita. You don't even allow him to sleep, mother. Sleeping and waking, he's only thinking of you. How happy a wife must be feeling. Now, Hanumanji says, mother, I want some prasanga, some episode from you which will make Rama realize that I have really met you. Some personal episode. She says, yes, my son. One day, your Lord and myself, we were relaxing in the forest. First, I was sleeping with my head in his lap. When I woke up, I told him, you put your head in my lap and I will watch while you sleep. My Lord was fast asleep. Jayanta, the son of Indra, came in the form of a crow and he was hurting my bosom. I felt hurt, but I could not cry out because my Lord was fast asleep. it would wake him up from his deep sleep. When he woke up and he found that my bosom was bleeding, he took a blade of grass and made it the Brahmastra and sent Jayanta right round the world until he came and fell back at our feet. I turned his face towards the Lord's feet, telling the Lord he's doing Sharanagati. Forgive him, my Lord, forgive him. This episode tells Sri Rama, if he could save me from Jayanta, the son of Indra, can't he save me from Ravana, who wants to cook me and eat me for his breakfast? Tell him I cannot live for him anymore, waiting for him. Go quickly, go and tell him. And then she takes from the edge of her sari, she has got a chudamani. It's a head jewel, a jewel which women wore in their hair, in their locks of hair. And she takes the chudamani and gives it to Hanumanji, saying, Hanuman, he sent me a jewel. I am sending him a counter jewel so that he will believe that you have authentic seen me and got this from me. Hanumanji takes this and decides to do what an ambassador should do. Before leaving, he says, Mother, I have some jobs to do. What is it, Hanuman? I have come as an ambassador. For your information, ladies and gentlemen, my devout listeners, please remember, according to international political law, the day an arrives in a foreign country, he must have an appointment with the Home Secretary. So Hanumanji says, I must meet the Darbar. I can't send my business card. I can only attract their attention. I will start destroying the park called Ashokavanika. That will draw their attention. And one day they will take me into the Darbar. Before leaving, he tells Mother, don't worry, Mother. There are many, many Vanaras in our army. I am only a courier messenger. I am an ordinary Vanara. There are many great Vanaras in the army of my Lord. Just to tell you how humble he is. Nahi prakrishta preshyante, preshyante hitare janaha. The best are still there. I am only a courier messenger, postman. That's all that I am. They are very big Vanara who can come and fight along with Rama and win you back to the world of Rama. Now he decides to destroy Ashokavanika, sits on the arch there with an uprooted tree in hand and crying out, Hail to Rama! Hail to Sugriva! Hail to Lakshmana! Dasoham Kosalindrasya Ramasya Klishta Karmanaha Hanuman Shatru Sainyanam Nihanta Marutatmaja Naravana Sahastrami Yudhe Pratibalam Bhavet Shilabhitu Praharataha Padapaitcha Sahastrashaha Ardaitva Purim Lankam Abhivadya Chamaitilim Samruddhato Gamishyami Mishatam Sarvarakshasam. Whenever it is necessary that you should talk about yourself, you should. My master Dikshar had a very stock joke. Whenever he used to speak about humility, he said, don't talk about yourself. So one stupid fellow was listening to his Ramayana. He went for an interview. The interviewer said, what is your name? I don't talk about myself. What is your degree? I don't talk about myself. What are your years of experience? I don't talk about myself. Where it is necessary, you have to talk about yourself. Hanuman is sitting on the arch, says, Hail to Rama. Hail to Lakshmana. Hail, jai ho, Lakshman ji ki, Ram ji ki, Sugriv ji ki. And then he says, my name is Hanuman. I will destroy your Lanka. And while it's being destroyed, I'll go back to Maithili. Bow down to her, Abhivadya cha Maithilim. And as you're watching, you stupid Rakshasas, my plane will take off and I'll go back to Rama. You can't do anything to me. That shows the bravery, the self-confidence that Hanumanji has. On this point, we realize that Hanumanji's bravery is something totally different from an ordinary warrior's bravery. He is fighting for Rama, by Rama, and of Rama. So many people are sent to battle against him. Jambumali is killed. The sons of the ministers are killed. Senapati Panchakas are killed. What is the worst part of this incident is Akshakumara, who is one of the sons of Ravana, is killed. Just to tell you that this is a rehearsal for Putrashoka. He is going to lose Indrajit also. Ravana is being given the taste of Putrashoka. Then when Akshakumara dies, he cannot bear it anymore. He says, Indrajit, Go and attack that Vanara who has come. Go. And Indrajit takes the Brahmastra. With the Brahmastra, he attacks Hanumanji. I hope you know, Brahmastra is the senior most weapon in the world. Brahmaji is next to Narayana. So any Astra coming from Brahma, you have to bow down to. I hope you remember Mahabharata narration. When the Narayana Astra is sent by Karna, the Lord says, Arjuna, no way of counteracting it. Just jump off the chariot, take off your shoes and bow down. It won't attack. Bhima says, I will try to attack. He says, don't do that, Bhima, don't do that. You will have to pay for it. Please remember, when a big Astra comes, you have to just submit. That is the only way to counteract it. That's the only way to nullify it also. Hanumanji finds that Brahmastra has tied him. To add insult to injury, the Rakshasas think, we will tie him with a rope. When you tie a person who has been tied by Brahmastra with a rope, then the Brahmastra's effect is gone because the Brahmastra is insulted. That is the concept. Brahmastra is invisible, you know. The weapon of Brahma is invisible. They think that this Vanara is very clever, very strong, so taking double precaution, they tie him with ropes. When the Brahmastra effect is gone, the ropes are like tassels for him, silken tassels. Now he is taken into the darbar of Ravana and he watches Ravana in action. He had seen Ravana fast asleep in inebriate third degree of drink, as Shakespeare calls it, the third degree of drink, totally exhausted after a late night party. Now he sees Ravana sitting on the throne. What power, what splendor, what proficiency, what strength of arms, what charismatic personality. One man with one head and one crown and two kundalas looks so impressive. Imagine one man with 10 heads and 10 crowns and 20 kundalas. How Ravana would have looked with all that burnished gold, dark person, burnished gold, red eyes, sitting there on the throne. Hanumanji is all admiration.
Aho rupam, aho dhairyam, aho sattvam, aho dyutihi, aho rakshasa rajasya, sarvala rakshana yuktata.
Hanumanji, what's happened to you? You were a Rama Bhakta. Now you're praising Ravana. What power, what splendor, what prosperity, what loveliness, what charismatic personality. What is wrong with you, Hanumanji? Hanumanji says, he has everything minus dharma. He has everything, but he has a basic weakness. And what is that? He had an evil eye on other men's wives. Paradara vimshanam. That was going to be the bane, the weakest point in the strong man.
Yadi adharmo na balavan syat, syadayam rakshaseshwaraha, syadayam suralokasya, sashakrasya picha rakshitam. If he did not have adharma in him,
Ravana could have ruled Indra's Amravati, but he is going to fall. And what a fall it was, my countrymen, that you and I and all of us fell. Such a great man, so powerful, so charismatic, that even the great Hanumanji is admiring.
Aho rupam, aho dhairyam, aho sattvam, aho dyutihi, aho rakshasa rajasya, sarva lakshana yuktata.
Sometimes in our movies, the villains are more handsome than heroes, no? You must have seen. Sometimes they are more handsome. Unfortunately, because of their lack of character, they fall. That is what the story tells you. From times immemorial, every story, every movie, every drama, every piece of literature was to tell you, behave like Rama, don't behave like Ravana. That is the meaning. This is literature teaching you that you should behave like Rama or you will be destroyed like Ravana. Hanumanji now enters the courtroom. He is not given a seat. When I was a child, those days we didn't have too many movies. We had drama. You know, drama was very good in those days. I'm talking of several years back now, 40, 50 years back. There was one Rajamanikam Pillai in Madras. He would play the role of Hanumanji. I don't know, some theater trick he had. You had the hose pipe, you know, the tubes. He would somehow find that all the tubes would pile up into one big heap and he would sit on that. It was lovely to watch him sitting there, almost equal to the throne of Ravana. And then Hanumanji begins to speak. Look at the propriety and decorum of Hanumanji's words.
Ravana, Rakshasendra, Harishastvam, Brata, Kushalamabravi.
Hanumanji belongs to that tribe which will speak of Rama wherever he finds. Even in the court of Ravana, he will find an excuse to speak on Ramayana. There was a king called Dashratha. He had four sons. The eldest was banished against the law of primogeniture to the forest with his wife and his brother Lakshmana. Sri Rama was wandering in the forest. At that time, his wife was missing. Parliamentary language, clear. No accusation, no unwarranted accusation, no using of the word abduction, kidnapping, which is so common in our newspapers today. All indecent language we use in public nowadays. There's no decency at all. Hanumanji says his wife was missing. And he searched for her high and low. Came across Vali and Sugriva. Vali he killed with one arrow. Your Lord Rama is known for one arrow, one word, and one wife. Only one. One arrow. He finished Vali. Don't worry. He has got many more arrows for you. That is the veiled threat. That is the veiled threat. I hope you understand what I mean. It's the veiled threat. You know who Vali is, Ravana? Vali is the fellow who brought you like a toy for his child to play in the cradle. That Vali was disposed by the Lord with one arrow. And Sugriva was made the king. I am one of Sugriva's ministers. My name is Hanuman. I'm Vayuputra. How did I come here? Not by aircraft. You take a Pushpaka Vimana, I fly. I came flying across the ocean, and I wandered in your Lanka. While I wandered in Lanka, in the Ashoka Vanika, I found Mother Sita. Please return her to Rama. Give him a big hand. Decorous language, decent language. An ambassador represents his country. An ambassador cannot let down his country by speaking indecent words in the parliament. He cannot call the king a kidnapper. He cannot call him names because Ravana will say, do you have eyewitness? There was one eyewitness and that was Jatayu, he died. Do you know? Did you see me carrying her away? No. He can't speak words which will hurt the decency of the court. And that's why he says, I wandered in Lanka and I found Mother Sita in your Ashoka Vanika. Please return her to Sri Rama. No, says the 20 eyes of Ravana. How dare you advise me? I will not. If you will not, I will threaten you. Very soon you will hear the twang of Sri Rama's bow, Jhankara. His bow twang will be heard and he will destroy you and your dynasty and you and your whole family and take away Mother Sita from here. This is the warning I give you.